What's going on, guys? This is Codex here, back with another video. Today's video will be about the trip mine. As you know, the trip mine is a throwable. What I mean by that, a trip mine, you can usually throw it and then it'll occupy a specific space. It'll only detonate when an enemy target is generally close or very close to the trip mine. So then I generally found the trip mine a lot more useful when you want to close off a certain section of a house. Let's say, for instance, you don't want anybody to rush through a door. So you might as well throw a trip mine just so that you can prevent them from rushing up the door. The only way they can push through the door, it's either by setting off the trip mine or destroying it. A widget gives you a little bit of, how could you say, a gap for you to escape and evade, or be aware from where your enemy targets are going to be coming from. However though, what I can tell you about the trip mine is that I found it a lot more useful when it came down to search and destroy, and also domination, and also hardpoint. The reason why I include domination and hardpoint as one category, because when you play the two game modes, and your enemy targets will always, I mean always, will come out from specific entry points. So then you might as well use the trip mine to set a booby trap for those specific points, as long as they don't see where the trip mines land or where they are situated mostly. However though, when it comes down to search and destroy, if you're on the defensive side, you might as well use the trip mine so that you can, so that you can lock down a site a lot more easily when it comes down to that. Let me give you an example of how useful they can be in search and destroy. When you're in search and destroy, there's a defensive side and an offensive side. You can utilize the trip mine a lot more useful on the defensive side, especially when it comes to bomb site A and bomb site B. Before you rush into an enemy building, you can set booby traps on the bomb site or at the entry point, so that they cannot, I repeat, so that they cannot push through easily. But then you have to do a good job into concealing your trip mine so that they don't see it, unless they got the perk that allows you to see where the trip mines are situated. So then with domination and hardpoint in particular, you can put the trip mines at specific entry points of where the domination flag is, or where the hardpoint flag is. If the hardpoint has shifted and you and your squad manages to get to the point first compared to the enemy team, you can set up booby traps on doors and also on entry points, such as gates or arches, or even corners to be exact. But then may I stress something out? With the trip mine, it's not like the trophy system of where you can throw it and pick it up again. Like, as soon as you throw it, you cannot pick it up again, like ever again, up until it explodes or up until you die. So then what happens, if you plant a trip mine at a specific location and then afterwards you end up dying, what happens, the trip mine immediately explodes. And the sad thing about it, as soon as it explodes, it won't even damage the enemy target, even if they're directly on top of it, as soon as you die and the trip mine explodes. So then I would love to say that's it for today, guys. I'll see you in the next video, in the next one. Peace.